This integral seems trivial. But you have to be careful. Try it yourself first and then watch a video to check whether you avoided the trap. So, you have the function z to the power minus 1 plus 3i, its contour, norm of z equals 1, so the unit circle, x reverses 1 in positive direction, and then some more information is given that your f of z is such that the branch is chosen such that the argument of z is between 0 and 2 pi, so the branch cut is along the positive real axis in this case. Yeah, but what's the problem? There are no singularities of f of z on or inside C, so we can just use Cauchy-Gaussin and conclude that our integral equals 0. So is this correct or is there a step somewhere wrong? It is subtle, but the answer is wrong. This part is correct, so there are no singularities of f of z on or inside C. So why is this wrong? Well, there was some information given here about the argument, so that's not given. We need to do something with that. And what's that? Well, we have a branch cut over here, so along the real axis. So our contour is intersecting the branch cut. So our function, so what's going wrong is that our function is not analytic inside C, because we have a branch cut over here, and that function even defined. So how should we deal with that? How can we even do such an integral? Well, the trick is as follows. You cannot cross the branch cut, stay away from it, so you take limits. So you start slightly above and then you end up slightly below. So you take limits, a going from above to 0 and b going from below to 2 pi. So a is not 0, b is not 2 pi, but you just take the limit. So you do not cross the branch cut, you don't get there. You parameterize z equals e to the power I theta, of course. You integrate from a to b. You substitute e to the power I theta in the function, and dz becomes I times e to the power I theta d theta. And now your integral is okay in terms of theta, because your boundaries are going from slightly above 0 to slightly below 2 pi, like this, so just avoiding your branch cut. Now, okay, you could have a technical problems, of course, when evaluating this integral, but fortunately it's really nice, because here we will get an e to the power minus I theta and an e to the power I theta, so those cancel out. So you are left with e to the power I theta times 3i, so e to the power minus 3 times theta. So this will be our integrand. The factor of I you can just take in front, of course. I you can compute the antiderivative. You get I divided by minus 3 times e to the power minus 3 times theta between the boundaries. Then you plug in boundaries, upper boundary minus lower boundary, and you are over here. No problems up till now. Then we have to take the limits. So now we are going to approach our branch cut. And then you see here a problem could arise, but let's see whether we can compute the limit here. So a to 0 and b to 2 pi, and we see there's fortunately no problem in those functions. You can just plug in the values of 2 pi and 0, and there we have our answer. So if you have an integral like this, be careful, be always very careful if branch cuts are involved.